for you and me. M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E. Hey there, hi there, ho there, you're as welcome as can be.
M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E.
Mickey Mouse,
Mickey Mouse,
Mickey Mouse,
Mickey Mouse.
Forever let us hold our banner high,
high, high, high.
Come along and sing a song and join the Jamboree.
M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E. Mickey Mouse!
It's time for the Mouseketeers!
We're the Mouseketeers, we want to say hello and give three cheers for all of you who see us every day. You're okay, so welcome to our Mousekit Club. And by the way, while you're here, you're all the guests of the Merry Mouseketeers. We'd like to introduce ourselves to you, so proudly put on your Mousekit ears. It's time to meet the Mouseketeers.
Roll call.
Cheryl.
Bobby.
The way we get to see a mouse cartoon for you and me.
Mouse cartoon time now is here.
Today's mouse cartoon is
to study about?
Ancient history?
Love and mystery?
Mathematics?
Reading, spelling?
Storytelling? No, no, no. The study of musical instruments is the subject for today.
The study of musical instruments is the subject for today.
Did you ever stop to think when the band plays rink-a-tink where all the music comes from? From a toot and a whistle and a plunk and a boom.
That's where the music comes from.
Did you ever understand that a symphony so grand, so bright and yet sentimental?
And a toot and a whistle and a plunk and a boom
are very instrumental. For the horns go toot,
the woodwinds whistle,
the strings go plunk, plunk, toot.
Then the drums boom, boom, with a bing, zing, zoom,
and it comes out fine and true.
So remember what I say when the band begins to play, just where the music comes from.
From a and a and a and a boom.
That's where the music comes from.
Now, students, fly with me to the dawn of history. We'll start investigating the toot and the whistle and the plunk and the boom. Okay, boys, you're on.
Goo-la-ga-lug, goo-la-ga-lug.
When a caveman blew through an old cow's horn, right then and there, the first toot was born. Now let's look ahead in history, and here we are in Egypt, 2000 B.C.
And now on the banks of the river Nile, the toot has certainly changed its style, and the kind of a note that the caveman blows is not good enough for the old pharaohs.
No, it's not good enough for the old pharaohs.
Now, The longer they made these ancient trumpets, the lower they sounded. But one day, someone bumped into a very startling fact. He had discovered that changing a trumpet's shape did not in the least change its pitch. Now, let's go back to our whistle.
Goo-la-ga.
When this caveman blew on a tube of grass, the very first whistle came to pass. By using his head instead of his feet, some genius found a way to beat this problem in a manner neat. When our third caveman plunked on the string of his bow, it was the first plunk, as far as we know.
First you take the bow, and sometime later, add a little jar to make a resonator, add a few strings.
Listen how it rings, change the jar to a box of wood, slide the box down.
Ah, pretty good, add a few pegs to tune it fine and sharp. Change the shape a little, now it looks like a harp.
And here there are two ways to go. You can either plunk it, or play it with a bow. Caveman with his rhythmic slap have come all things that click or tap. Came rattles, bells, and we presume all other instruments that go boom.
So remember what we say when the toot, and a whistle, and a plunk, and a boom.
Because we like you.
M-O-U-S-E.
Musketeers, this is Jimmy Dodd again. Sure hope you enjoyed our 3D Jamboree and that you'll tell your friends to come and see us. Oh, and by the way, please leave your 3D glasses in the lobby. You see, these glasses are made especially for 3D and aren't to be used as sunglasses. Thanks for visiting us and have fun now and enjoy yourselves.
Yeah!